Today, we're going to be looking at the benefits of using an external graphics processor on Mac, which allows for improved gaming performance. In this episode, we'll be benchmarking games using the eGFX Breakaway Box, which has a RX560 GPU card inside. A big thank you to Intraware, Australian Sonnet Distributor, and AMD Australia for the eGPU loan. Please note, all these games shown today have been played on a 2018 13-inch MacBook Pro and are all playing at the same graphical settings. Anyway, let's begin with our first game, Divinity Original Sin 2. So this game has official eGPU support. Based on my testings, running Divinity Original Sin 2 without the eGPU, we are seeing an average frame rate of 17, and when the eGPU is connected, this increases to an average FPS of 45. I was hoping that this game would see 60 frames at high, but it doesn't. However, playing at medium will allow for 60 frames. Next up, we have the best action-adventure game on Mac, Rise of the Tomb Raider. Here is another game with official eGPU support. Without the eGPU, we are seeing an overall FPS of 14.39, and with the eGPU connected, this is pushed up to 40.32 on average. Playing at medium would increase the FPS closer to 60. Up next, we have the newest FPS game for Mac, Black Ops 3. This game is very well optimized for AMD graphics cards, so it runs great here, playing at 62 frames per second. Quite impressive, as compared to without the eGPU, it is unplayable at 15 frames on this Mac, as it doesn't have an AMD graphics card, which is required to play Black Ops 3 on Mac. Coming up next, we have the latest macOS racing game, Dirt 4. This game runs really great here with the eGPU. So for example, we are seeing around 22 FPS without the eGPU, and when it is connected, it is going up to about 62 frames per second. Not bad if you ask me, not bad. 62 frames is very playable. Next, here we have the most popular Mac game, Fortnite. Why is this still so popular? Anyways, Fortnite isn't very well optimized for Mac, so don't take the performance of this game as an example of this eGPU. Anyway, with the eGPU connected, we are getting around 35 to 45 FPS, and without it, it is 15 to 20. 35 to 45 is perfectly fine, like that's playable, but closer to 60 frames would be much better. You could obviously play at medium and it would hit around close to 60 frames though, so that is worth considering. Next up, we have the really weird game, Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. So this game is in early access, so keep that in mind, which also means that the performance here should increase when it fully releases. It's also worth noting that when you add lots of units onto the map, the frame rate can drop somewhat. Anyway, we are getting around 20 to 30 frames on average without the eGPU, which is actually not that bad, but when the eGPU is connected, we are getting around 60 to 67 frames. This is not bad. This game is pretty well optimized for Mac, so far, in my opinion, anyway. So here we have Rocket League, one of the most popular multiplayer Mac games. Rocket League runs great for Mac, as you'll soon find out. Without the eGPU, it is running at 35 frames per second, compared to around 55 to 60 with the eGPU connected. Without the eGPU though, the game would sometimes see random lag spikes. But anyway, I'm surprised how well this game runs on integrated graphics cards anyway. Anyone else? Our last game here is CSGO. While CSGO is an older title, and it also doesn't utilize Metal, it utilizes OpenGL, it is still very popular and it runs great on Mac. Without the eGPU, it is playable at 45 frames per second, and with the eGPU connected, it usually stays around 100 frames. Not bad if you ask me. So, what can we take from all this? This eGFX Breakaway box is the perfect gaming solution for low-end Macs, and in some cases, high-end Macs, since you can place a compatible eGPU inside, such as the RX560 for instance. This allows you to play most games at 1080p, high, and in most cases, close to or over 60 frames. So it could be compared to playing games on console, for instance. But what do you guys think of all this? Are you going to pick up this eGPU? Let me know in the comments below. Anyway, thanks for watching.